Hi everyone, it's Colette with Out Late But Great, your host here on the channel on Tuesdays. I hope this finds you well on a Tuesday night. Our community was hit very, very hard this past weekend with the Orlando massacre. On Sunday morning, I got up, I actually slept in, and I was feeling really good. And I couldn't find my phone. And I needed to go dilate in the morning. And my boyfriend already knew what had happened, but he didn't really want me to look online, didn't want me to go on the computer. And I found my phone finally, and I saw what was happening. And I just froze. I literally froze in my living room, and I didn't know what to think of this. And it was just the strangest day Sunday. And finally, I think it was 7 o'clock, I forced myself to get out of the house and stop reading stuff and to go to the gym. And I went running and stuff, but I literally, all I kept doing was just crying and just feeling really confused and really overwhelmed and thinking about the implications of what had just happened. And then, Monday rolled around and I didn't sleep on Sunday and I went to work and yesterday I think was probably the worst day. I just started reading about the people who had passed away and I kept thinking about all the thousands of people that showed up to donate blood. And I kept thinking about just the outpouring of love and kindness and seeing the cities change their lights to rainbow. And to top it off, I got an email from my mother. And for those of you who don't know, I've been estranged from my family ever since I came out as transgender. And I was just so overwhelmed and I kept crying at my desk, trying to keep it together, but I just felt like my community and the people I love, it was just an assault, a direct attack on our community. And I don't know, I was just allowing myself to read all the sad stuff and really try to see what really happened that night. And I just kept forcing myself to read it because I'm you can't be numb to this. You can't be desensitized. This is your community. So I kept I just kept looking at it. And thankfully, last night I got to have a hangout session with Michelle and Jim from Atlanta on the channel. And that was so awesome because it just felt so good to connect with them because, they're close to that where the situation happened. And I totally thought about them thinking God, what if they just wanted to go out for the night and that when they were there and then, just thinking about I don't know, you think of all sorts of stuff. And, but anyway, it was really awesome to connect with them. And, I started seeing really, really alarming things on Facebook from some trans girls I know who were talking about, I don't want to live in this life anymore. This isn't worth it. And I just think a lot about the people that stay in the closet and think, this obviously proves my point. And I just keep thinking no, we need to stick together and we need to channel our anger and our rage to do some progress. And today, for instance, today's a little bit better. I'm just super, super exhausted, but I'm just trying to figure out what I can do just in my own community and also how I can kind of partner up with other people in the community to find a way to ban assault rifles, do common sense gun reform, more education for LGBT visibility. I don't know. And, I found it really interesting that my mom contacted me because obviously she saw the news and thought, oh, that could be you in the club. So I don't know what that holds for my relationship with her, but I'm curious to see if that's happening to other people in the community, if they've been estranged and now their family is reaching out to them. But for me, I just really feel like I want to be around my community. I want to be around people I love and just kind of feel safe, I guess, because the safe haven, the gay club, isn't a safe haven anymore. And I don't know. I'm just rambling, but I don't know. If any of you guys are affected and you know people who've passed away, like, I just hope you know that everyone here on Out Late But Great is thinking about you, is sending you positive love. And if you need to talk to any of us, don't hesitate. We just have to really, really stick together and push back from any other negativity. And like, I've been seeing like some other like preachers and stuff posting crap about how it's great that this happened because now there's like 49 less like perverts in the world, and saying all this like terrible, terrible stuff. And I just find myself getting more and more enraged because I just don't feel like as a country, as a culture, that stuff should be tolerated. And I really, really hope this, out of this terrible, awful, horrible situation, I just hope there's some progress that happens. And on a final note, I did see something super, super cool today. And I was coming back from lunch at work and I looked up at the sun, and there was a rainbow around the sun, this perfect rainbow. And even now I'm getting chills. Like, I just stopped and I'm like, what are the chances that there's a rainbow around the sun? And I started thinking, did the city like put that up there? Is it like moisture in the air, or is it, you know, something else? And I know most people will be like, oh, it's just science, it's just like precipitation or whatever, but I just kind of feel like it's something more than that. And if that's kind of dumb, I don't care. But I just really think it might be like the spirit of those people. And a friend of mine sent me a really cool like Native American thought about the rainbow around the sun, and basically how it's a symbolization of transformation, and how everyone will come together. It doesn't matter your background, your race, your gender, whatever, there's going to be equality and like basically an enlightenment. And I really hope that's the case, because that would be quite beautiful. And you know, no one at my work's talking about it. I don't know. It's different how some people that aren't a part of the community just kind of like, oh, that's terrible, but they don't really think about it, I guess. I don't know. But anyways, you guys, I'll stop rambling on here. I just hope you guys know that I care about all of you who watch this channel, and, you know, hang in there and just know that there's strength in numbers and that you're loved and that you matter. And I will talk to you guys next week. Take care. Bye.